Well, good morning, beautiful people, and welcome back. Today is the day after the NND Emosako DK Shiro event that we went to. So, if you haven't seen that video, go check that one out. It's a pretty good video with lots of fish in it. And today's task will be first quick task. Get that off the cover so it can dry out inside, and then we're going back indoors. We're going to do the little tank because we need to get the fish we got yesterday into that tank. I want to clean that tank out so it's got fresh water, and then give the fish in there a quick PP dip, and then get him into his new little temporary home, and then crack on the building up. So, very important we get that done as quick as we can now. And these guys, I put the UV on last night, so we will sort the clarity issue out, and eventually we should be able to see these fish again. So, I'll catch you in a bit, guys. So, what we got to do is clean these guys out, because we've still got an issue with some smaller fish flicking. This little guy in the corner, Oharawaki, he's looking as miserable as sin. And we scraped a fluke, we couldn't find any fluke, so we've got one or two issues. We had a load of bubbles on the surface forming that weren't going away. So what I did was gave them a 50% water change, and that helped most of them out. And the only other issue I could think of is possibly costia, but I've scraped and we haven't found any. So I want to get number 12, who's still in his box, into here, because if I put him in the main pond with the clarity that's in there, I'm not going to be able to keep an eye on him for the first few days. So he's going to come in here for a little bit until we get the little pond sorted out, and then he'll go into the little pond. But his issue is either costia or it's something to do with the food. I've been trying them on, just to get them on a bigger pellet, I've been trying them on the New Forest Koi Vitality, and they don't seem to like it. And the only thing I can think of, it does cloud the water slightly. So the only thing issue I can think of is possibly it's put too much nutrients into this water, and they're not liking the quality. There you go, look, flicking already. And he's been sat here 2 minutes. That guy is hardly moving. He spends most of his time under the air stone. The little shower's not looking too bad. This little guy down there is another one with issues. That guy there is flicking. Another kajaku. Following now, there you go. So what we're going to do, clean these guys out, get them all PP dipped, get the Shiro out, give him a PP dip, and it is going to be just a quick dip. Now I've seen how to do that. So I will come back to you when we've got a nice clean tank. So I think I've found the issue with this slimy crap. That normally only appears after about 3 weeks. This tank was only cleaned out last week, And a water change midweek, 50%. There's definitely some kind of, you know, nasty slime crap. So, we'll get this cleaned up, get the fish back in, and get them PP'd off. And we'll get the new fish added. Oh dear. So guys, I got given some of this stuff. And I was told I can use it as a disinfectant. So I pour a little bit in the bottom of the tank, got it on the cloth, started cleaning everything down, and do you think I could breathe? Oh my god, this stuff is toxic as anything. It's burning my eyes, it's burning my throat. So now I've got to fill it all up, fully dilute it as best I can, and empty it out without choking. I've had to open the window, I've had to shut that door, I have to get this all over. But there is no way I am putting fish in that tank before it, that fucking stench has gone. That's burning my eyes. Thank God I was wearing gloves, because I don't think I'd have any skin left on my fingers. So, nice tip from our local koi dealer. It's nearly bloody killed me. So yeah. I ain't using that stuff again. Oh, Christ. It's not coming out my nose. I've got my eyes running. Throat's burning. I've had to have a ton of drink. Oh my God. Right, so if you're ever given this stuff, use as a disinfectant. No, no, no. Alright, so now I've got all the water out. Oh, so glad I diluted that. So bad. Right. Oh my god. The fumes on that stuff was just unbloody real. How to kill yourself with formaldehyde. Great tip that was. Jesus. Oh, lucky I don't end up with COPD after that, I tell you. Right, so the next task is dry the bejesus out of this tank and then leave it for a bit. See if we can still slightly smell that stuff. If we can, then it's going to need to be diluted again. Rinsed out. So a job that should have took me just a couple of hours, it's now taking me the best part of the frigging day. Not happy. Got loads of other stuff to do. There we go, these guys are chilling out there. It's number 12 in the box I'm worried about, because he's been in there best part of 24 hours now, I would say. So the sooner I can get him out, the better. So I'm gonna motor on with this job, and I'll catch you in a bit, guys. So, there he is. No name yet, just number 12.
Come on. Oh, little dude.
Very difficult.
It's not gonna measure. Just about 20. So, looking a little bit washed out. That's because he's been in bowls and in bags and he's a little bit stressed. I just love the pattern. It's a rich, deep sumi. Nice sumi in the packs. Nice sumi in the dorsal. I'll be able to see that when I get him in the tank. But we're going to give him a quick dip. That helicopter's doing my head in. He's been over all day. And another one's doing my head in. Maybe. It's a damn dog wants to go out, but I'll do this first. Get him settled in the tank. And then we'll get the others moved in. Seriously, that helicopter's driving me up the wall. I've already got a headache from that. Formaldehyde fumes. Needs just adding to it. But yeah, eat this fish. A lot of sumi still to come up. What has come up is nice and rich. Nice creamy head. Yeah, really pleased with that fish. Got the one I wanted. And when I got him out, Alan Tate said he was looking at that one. So, that tells me I've done alright for a pick. It's not going to get to the biggest, we know that. Because we just don't have the money to feed him that much. 2 kilogram of sake akari a day. It's beyond my budget, but I did get some, so we'll try him. I just want him to get a decent body shape. Should be lovely. Right, so time for his quick dip, and we'll see you in a little bit.
Bend your face.
What the hell's going on?
Where's my big pun?
Yeah. It's coming.
Didn't come out of a big pun, did it?
Came out of quite a decent size vat, yeah.
Was it just ones that had been chosen that were in there?
No, the whole 50 of them were in there. And then they were in the bowls and you chose the fish and found your certificate. And then mark the bags up and catch them at the end. So there we go. Everybody's back in the tank. He's doing fine. There we go. Number 12. It's not far off the Neo size. Everyone back. Everybody's had a PP dip. Oh, Wacky's swimming around a little bit, but he's not doing great, so he's probably going to go the same way as the BIQ Kuro. He's acting pretty similar. Anyway, here he is. Side comes right the way round. Chance of seeing me to come up still. And there's your dorsal. It's pretty even all the way down. White black, white black. Yeah, I'm starting to build a collection for the future now. And a few more Japanese fish.
Okay, there we go. So what should have took a couple of hours turned into an absolute nightmare. First with a formaldehyde, nearly killing it. Then I had all sorts of issues putting the pump in. In the end I decided that the suckers are now no good, so what I've had to do is string a load of cable ties together. And cable tie him in and hold him and fix him in place with some tape. He don't look great. I'm a bit worried about the fish cutting themselves on it, but it was either that or go and get a brand new bloody pump. And I've spent a fortune just recently. So we had to do a cheap option. Then we had the other pump and filter. That took me about an hour to get it to prime properly. And I went absolutely ballistic trying to sort that out. It's not too bad. That cable has come out. What the f... I'll have to sort that air hose out, as that should be around the back of the pump. That pipe there, that should be a bit down as well. It should be underneath that, holding that in. A few minor issues. I'll have a chill out. But yeah, doing really nice. Not going to feed today. There's been a lot of stress on these fish. So, tomorrow we'll get out a little bit. Temperature's still down. I'm just gonna let that build up. Dropped it quite a bit for these guys, what they're used to. Here's a new guy. His water was absolutely freezing. So he's been used to a colder temp. These guys are used to a warmer temp. For the next few days I should just let the room temperature bring the water temperature up before I switch on the heater. So what should have been build day 10 has just been fick about with the tank again. But yeah, I think you'll agree, it's so much better. Let's hope we can sort those issues out. Harawaki. Yeah. My luck with Harawakis is terrible. Doesn't look like it's going to be changing soon. For me, they either die or they turn bleeding orange. So, we'll see if we can invest in one in the future. Quite a way in the future. Right then guys, I'll catch you later. Tomorrow we can get back to working on the bleeding pond. And the filtration system's doing my head in because the Lego's not working. So I'm going to have to figure out a new idea. I'm a bit concerned about Neo here. After his PP dip yesterday, he's been pretty irritated. Well, let me get closer. Get out of the way, number 12. Yeah, he's looking very irritated. Okay, looking a bit depressed. There we go. Oh, one drop. Yeah, there's something not right there. So one, them two. Just two irritated fish now. They did have a PP dip yesterday, and I've noticed that when the fish came out, they looked a little bit brown for some reason, and most of them have come back. Most of them that are white have come back, except for Neo. He's still looking. Patches of brown on him. Now I'm wondering if that's the mucus that's been affected by the PP, and that's what's causing him irritation. A bit like when you've been sunburnt and your skin's peeling off. So I'm wondering if it would be advisable to get him out and just scrape that dead mucus off. I don't know if anybody's ever encountered that sort of thing before, after a PP dip. But yeah, I think that's what I'm going to do, because he's all over the shop at the moment. He's all down in the dumps. Doesn't seem to be. A similar kind of issue. So I think both fish have got some kind of different issue. And they were fine before the PP bath, and now last night Neo was sulking like that one, like the khaki. This morning he's all over the place, so I mean, that's just weird. I've never seen a fish dump. Number 12 is doing alright. He's even has a little bit of food on the side, just a tiny little bit. Yeah, let's give him a feed today. Put that up. Pellets of sake. And a pinch of peanut and junior for the little guys. One thing I have noticed, though, Harawaki has become a lot more active. So the PP dips helped him. It just seems to have knocked Neo a bit for six. Anyway, I'm gonna get up, gonna get dressed, and we're gonna start working on the little pond. because the day outside is beautiful.
Guys, it's time to make the slope. It's going to head down towards the bottom drain. You have to forgive the background noise because, along with DIY Britain, we have also got an armed raid across the road. So if you hear the shouts of armed police, it's nothing to do with me. It's them across the road again. So the original plan was to put the boards in, then put some sand on top to make the slope, and then I realised if that sand got wet it would never dry out and then it would rot the boards. So I had to think of a way around that. Originally I thought about putting the boards in and then building this step on top, building a slope in, cutting polystyrene, and then I realised it's going to be near enough impossible to cut that diagonally all the way across and keep it even, a nice even slope. So what I've come up with is to make some steps in the polystyrene, cover the steps with some expanding foam, smooth that off, and then we're going to put the boards up here on the top and actually give us a nice smooth glide down to the bottom drain. So I'm going to crack on with that and I'll come back to you in a bit. Well, good morning, beautiful people, and as you can see I haven't got very far. So what I started doing was measuring up the polystyrene to cut and start putting the sloping at the bottom, and then I realized that's going to be an issue if I haven't put the banding on first. So I started putting the banding on, then it got rained out, and the next day was too wet to come and work. But it's pretty fortunate really, because if I'd loop round again to look at where the window's going, and he's saying that if I leave it as it is, and the water will be able to get through these little gaps in between and cause me an issue further down the line with the water going inside, going down, and then rotting the bottom. So what we've got to do is take not two steps back but three or four steps back and take the whole thing apart, get some silicone sealant between each one, each layer, and put it all back together, let that set, and the silicone should A, stop it moving, and B, stop the water getting through. And I've come up another level, so I have got another level made, because when I offered the barrels up to the pipe we only had half a barrel's worth of water for the water line because we're going to be gravity fed. So we've come up another level just to give me more water in the barrel, and I'm hoping I don't have to come up another level, because then that'll make it ridiculously high. And what it was that's allowed me to do is move the window up a bit in the design. So the window is going to sit somewhere here, and we're going to have a slightly larger window. So I've got to order that. So while I got rained off, what I started doing was the filtration inside, and we have issues with the Lego. The Lego is actually, with the glue, it's melting and it's hardly sticking on. So I've got to figure out another way of fixing that grid in place. So that's another headache I've not got through. As you can see, it's been so difficult to line them up, those Lego bits. That one should be over to the right a bit more, and then try and get a brick in on top to inside when the glue is drying. And I've obviously knocked it. The third one I put in, that was all out of line, so
I had to pull that off. They're not that strong inside, so what I've started doing, if I come over here, is we started work on the backing channel. Now, got the first one sorted, it's all sealed round, it's going to be the top. As you can see, I have cut out the bottom and placed in some grid. This is just guttering grid, stops the leaves going in the guttering. And that should help the media sit on. And rather than have holes drilled through it, like most people do on a backy shower, there you go, that grid. So that shouldn't block up as fast as holes that are drilled in the bottom. So that's as far as we've got. We've got another issue in the tank.